Well, it is the world's best-selling album, Michael Jackson's Thriller. It constantly tops the lists of the greatest albums of all time and has sold more than 60 million copies. But its greatest legacy is the iconic music video for Thriller. The Thriller mini-movie video clip ran for 14 minutes and it thrust an unknown model, Ola Ray, into the spotlight. In this exclusive interview with Craig Bennett, a world exclusive, she reveals how her time in the limelight wasn't all that thrilling.
The year was 1983. Bob Hawke became PM. The first mobile phone call took place and a video clip that would change the music world forever was born. One year earlier, Michael Jackson's Thriller album was released and the King of Pop wanted to create a big budget and epic music video to go with the title track. The iconic music video was narrated by horror king Vincent Price and directed by John Landis, famous for An American Werewolf in London. And it was the first time fans saw Michael Jackson have an on-screen romance.
Look out!
Can we get out of here?
No, I'm enjoying it.
The role of his Thriller girlfriend went to former Playboy playmate Ola Ray.
I got a call from John Landis. He wanted me to come to his office and he started explaining to me what he wanted me to do. It was a little confusing at first, but then when he started to play Thriller, I mean, I got so excited. I was like, oh my God.
Wow.
I said, this is Michael Jackson. I said, you have to give it to me. I said, I know how to handle him. Trust me, I have experience with this, and so.
You got the job.
Well, he said, I'll call you in 2 weeks, and he called me after 2 weeks.
Ola had been working as a model since she was 15 and knew how to light up the screen. But it was her thrilling chemistry with the King of Pop that sparked rumours the pair might be more than co-stars. And Ola plans to spill all the juicy details in a sizzling, soon-to-be-released tell-all.
So I do talk about our second kiss in his trailer.
There was more than one kiss.
I talk about him taking a little something off for me.
My goodness. You had such a chemistry. It was like a real romance.
Well, in a way, it was like a real romance.
As word spread that Michael was creating such a momentous music vid masterpiece, fans flocked to the filming location, as did many famous faces.
Jackie Onassis, I saw her when she came in, and she came in, you know, in her limo and everything, and I'd asked Michael, I said, can I go meet her? He said, no. He said, this one, he said, I have to go and talk to her about business.
Are you all right?
Another aspect of your amazing performance in Thriller is that scream that seems to go on forever.
Get away!
I just really wanted to do the best scream for Michael. I really wanted to make the best scream. And I remember it was so funny, John took Michael and I into the editing. And John was letting my screen roll over the music. And Michael was like saying, are you gonna keep that in there? And John was looking at me, he said, yes, that's the best part. He said, we have to keep the screen.
Was it a bit overwhelming at first for you?
No, it wasn't overwhelming. I just felt really good that I was able to work with him and I was chosen for that part. And Michael made me feel so comfortable with him always laughing and joking and playing, you know. He was so funny.
I had this huge grin on my face.
It wasn't overwhelming until afterwards.
The star of one of the biggest music videos of all time was behind bars.
After the mega success of the Thriller video, life became a real-life horror story for Ola.
After Thriller being so big, I had a lot of people always coming over to my house. And that is kind of what started it, because I was completely sober before.
And they took advantage of
you. And they were just putting it out and here, and I guess maybe wanting to be a part of. You know, I started using. And then I was kidnapped and held under someone's house for a couple of months.
What?
Yeah.
How did you escape?
He let me out.
So what was rock bottom for you?
The drug bust at my house. I was using. What people don't know about that, and I talk about it in my book, I was dating an undercover cop. I didn't know it at the time. I found out after I came out of jail. And he did that to me and called the television station and had them sitting there when I came out with handcuffs. And so it was a fake arrest. I never did any prison time. And all that stuff about me being Miss Drug Pen or whatever, King Pen woman, I mean, that was all meth. That was all crazy. But so my life had been exposed, first of all, me using. And then another thing for them to lie about all that they said happened to me. It was devastating.
Been the two of us need look no more.
It was 10 years ago that the world lost Michael Jackson. And in recent years, his legacy has been rocked by allegations that he was a pedophile. But Ola maintains Michael is completely innocent.
I didn't believe it, but yeah, it was horrifying to watch it from afar. But I still, to this day, don't believe that he's capable of doing that. And I actually think that broke him.
Ola Ray lost contact with Michael in his final years, but the bond they shared in Thriller was still strong. So much so, she believes his presence is all around her.
I've had a lot of different experiences with Michael's spirit.
Really?
He has come back to me so many times.
Does he tell you things, Ola?
He tells me a lot of things, but I'm not going to discuss it.
And it's in the book.
It's in the book, the thrill of it all.
I can't wait for that. All these years on, and we're talking 36 years,
yeah.
Thriller is still so loved. Why do you think that is?
I think that Michael and I put so much love into it, and that I think everyone felt that love, and we made it very special.
Come on, I'll take you.
Great interview there by Craig Bennett. And we have to also thank The Hollywood Show for giving us access to that interview.